Well, we have the cores and we're gonna start breaking down the radiators so we can get to the worn out core and get everything all cleaned up and start replacing. I guess the first thing we're gonna do is try to get this shutter assembly off here. These screws here are too badly corroded or rusted to get out with a screwdriver, so we're either gonna have to drill them or we'll see if these bolts will come out that hold this piece of angle to the tank. And these bolts also sandwich the tank to the housing. All right. What a mess. We started taking the bolts off from the tank to get this piece of angle off, and they've just, first two we tried just broke, so I'd imagine we could assume the rest are gonna follow suit. After the bolts are unbolted, we have to remove these bars here and here. So you can see most of these bolts broke. This side's really rotted. This is the bottom, so that kind of makes more sense. We were wondering if the, well, I'm not sure what exactly this part is called, but this bar here, we're wondering if that was indeed threaded also. Still haven't determined whether it is or not. Do you think that's threaded, or do you think it's just rot holding it in there?
I'm not sure.
I think it's just rot holding it in there, judging by the way that's moving. Yeah. That's just held in there by rust. But twisting them seems to loosen them up. Yeah. A lot of these nuts and bolts are breaking, or bolts anyway.
Gotta go.
Yep. We might have to use the air hammer. Probably. I'll hold this bar here and it's hard to believe this is only from 1983. It's about rotted as bad as something you'd see from the 50s or older. But I suppose these saw a lot of miles. Alright, here we go. I'll grab that piece of angle that fell, what's left of it. we'll have to use that to get measurements for making a new one. Alright, we have the other side done. They came apart much the same. Most of them broke, had to be driven out. The ones, bolts on the side here are, this part of the housing is threaded. This one came out. This one did not. Sounds like most of those over there are breaking, are they?
Yeah.
So far. So far every one of those broke. That means those are going to have to be drilled and tapped, unfortunately. Alright. So, all the bolts are out. And right now we're working on removing the tanks. Which looks like it's going to go pretty easy. That. Those look like they're in pretty good shape on the inside and out. Those will clean up nice. This is the bottom of the core. Now the new cores we got are not as thick as these cores. The guy told us that the thinner ones he had will actually cool better because they'll flow more air. He's a little more restrictive. I guess. I hope. Sounds like it's plausible. Hope it works out like he says. Look at those. Alright. We found the broken bolts from the side of the core, or excuse me, side of the radiator housing, are holding the core in. And since we're not using this core over again, we're just bending it up. So we can get the housing away from the core. We'll have to do this again on the other side. Alright, well, starting to get dark and we have this all broken down. Next we'll have to take these, sandblast them, clean them up, and get them ready for the new cores.